Namaskar and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the kind words. These are the concepts which I aspire for is very hard in the Indian bureaucracy. But if you persist with this, at times the decision makers or your boss is convinced, and especially if you deliver, then the path becomes easier. And I always believe that if you are a team player, you can be more effective rather than the normal pattern in which directions come from the top to bottom. But that's the way life is. I take this opportunity to congratulate Canada India Foundation for organizing this forum on higher education. I also take this opportunity to convey the greetings of Consul General Mr. Dinesh Bhatia to Canada India Foundation for holding this event. The Consul General is presently in India for official engagements, and that is one of the reasons I am here to represent the consulate. This event comes at an opportune time when the Canadian government has introduced the SDS, Student Direct Stream Program, for facilitating faster and simpler visa processing to international students from India, China, Philippines, and Vietnam. We all know that the number of Indian students in Canada has grown up to 124,000 last year, and this number is poised to grow in the coming years. With the number of Indian students increasing every year, it is imperative to have mechanisms which effectively address the growing concerns, not only regarding their safety and well-being, but also about all aspects related with opportunities available for employment and career advancement, and eventually helping them settle down in the country if they wish to. If we look at the level of official engagement between the two countries in the area of higher education, you will find that the joint statement, which was issued during the recent visit of Prime Minister of Canada to India, states that both the Prime Ministers noted the significant increase in number of Indian students in Canada and expressed satisfaction at the renewal of the MOU on higher education. They recognized the 50th anniversary of Shastri Indo-Canadian Institute in promoting understanding between India and Canada through academic activities and exchanges with the support of both governments to the institute. The leaders also agreed on the benefits of supporting the arts, sports and cultural activities in each other's country. The MOU aims towards fostering cross-border partnership focused on research excellence and industry-academic collaboration between India and Canada that brings robust innovation gains to both countries. This MOU, signed during the Canadian Prime Minister's visit, has now been approved by the Indian Cabinet. International students come to Canadian colleges and universities with high hopes. Many choose Canada because of the options available to work and stay in Canada after finishing studies as an international student, but they pay a much higher tuition fees compared to their domestic peers. This disparity is often linked to the fact that universities, colleges don't receive provincial funding for international students as compared to the domestic students. Even after paying a high premium, there is a huge gap in the number of students and the services that exist to support these students so that they can be successful in this new environment. There are scattered services across institutions which are not sufficient to support these students. In addition to making continuous adjustments to figure out the best way forward to fit into this new country, Very often they are forced to work part-time in coffee shops, factories, warehouses and stores in order to pay for the high fees and the high cost of living. The result is that these students are not able to focus on their studies and eventually lose out on the time to focus on building their careers and lives here. According to Canadian Bureau of International Education study, 51% of international students plan to apply for permanent residence in Canada after graduation, and this study also suggests many international students who want to stay feel that the labour market is difficult to access. Considering these challenges faced by most international students, it is imperative that the Indo-Canadian community, which is making a significant contribution in all walks of life here in Canada, take the initiative from within the community for putting in place measures to address the concerns and problems being faced by the students coming from India. There are more than 100 Indo-Canadian associations in Greater Toronto Area who are very active in one way or the other in preserving and propagating the diverse cultural heritage of India. If these associations may consider allocating some time and resources to address this issue as part of their calendar of events, it will definitely result in making some headway for finding ways and means at the community level for providing effective and meaningful support to those in need and create a platform to impress upon the authorities concerned to come up with policies and programs which lead to long-term solutions. This initiative taken by Canada India Foundation should therefore be seen as a step arising from within the community to address the challenges being faced by students coming from India. And now is the time for the Indo-Canadian community to come forward to add momentum to this initiative, as these students are the key to nurture the partnership between India and Canada in the future. Thank you.